Poem syndrome. What are the features of poem syndrome? As the name suggests, poems. So in poems, we have this polyneuropathy, organomegaly, endocrinopathy, M protein, and skin changes. Polyneuropathy, organomegaly, endocrinopathy, M protein, and skin changes. So what are the diagnostic criteria? So here we have the diagnostic criteria. So in diagnostic criteria, all of the following four criteria must be met. So one, it is polyneuropathy, monoclonal plasma cell proliferative disorder. All the four criteria must be met. Polyneuropathy, monoclonal plasma cell proliferative disorder, any one of the following. So in any one of the following, sclerotic bone lesions, Castleman's disease, elevated levels of vascular endothelial growth factor. So what should be elevated? Vascular endothelial growth factor. Bone lesions, how should be the bone lesions? Sclerotic, Castleman's disease, and elevated levels of vascular endothelial growth factor, and any one of the following. So four criteria must be present. One is polyneuropathy, other is monoclonal plasma cell proliferative disorder, and any one of the following, like sclerotic bone lesions, Castleman's disease, elevated levels of vascular endothelial growth factor, and any one of the following, organomegaly, splenomegaly, hepatomegaly, or lymphadenopathy. What organs? Splenomegaly, hepatomegaly, or lymphadenopathy. Extravascular volume overload. So what is this extravascular volume overload? Edema, pleural effusion, or ascites. Extravascular volume overload, edema, pleural effusion, or ascites. Endocrinopathy, adrenal, thyroid, pituitary, gonadal, parathyroid, and pancreatic. All endocrines, adrenal, thyroid, pituitary, gonadal, parathyroid, and pancreatic. Skin changes. So what are the skin changes? Hyperpigmentation, hypertrichosis, glomeruloid hemangiomata. Hyperpigmentation, skin is hyperpigmented, hypertrichosis, glomeruloid hemangiomata, plethora, acrocyanosis, flushing, white nails, flushing, acrocyanosis, plethora, papilledema, and thrombocytosis or polycythemia and papilledema. So the diagnostic criteria, so four criteria: polyneuropathy, monoclonal plasma cell proliferative disorder, any one of the following, sclerotic bone lesions, Castleman's disease, elevated levels of vascular endothelial growth factor, and any one of the following, organomegaly, extravascular volume overload, skin changes, endocrinopathy, and papilledema, and thrombocytosis and polycythemia. So patients usually have a severe progressive sensory motor polyneuropathy. So they will have a severe progressive sensory motor polyneuropathy, also associated with sclerotic bone lesions from myeloma. Also they'll have this sclerotic bone lesions from myeloma. So polyneuropathy occurs in 1.4% of myelomas. So in what percent of myelomas polyneuropathy occurs? 1.4%, but the POEM syndrome is only a rare subset of that group of myelomas. So unlike typical myeloma, so here in polyneuropathy, hepatomegaly and lymphadenopathy occur in about 2/3 of the patients, and splenomegaly is seen in 1/3. So unlike here in Poem syndrome. So what is happening in Poem syndrome? So there is hepatomegaly and lymphadenopathy. So this is seen in 2/3 and splenomegaly is seen in 1/3. So the lymphadenopathy frequently resemble Castleman's disease histologically. So how is the lymphadenopathy in a Poem syndrome? It resembles Castleman's disease. So this has been linked to IL-6 overproduction. So why this lymphadenopathy? Because of this interleukin-6 overproduction. So it resembles to that of Castleman's disease histologically. So what are the endocrine manifestations? The endocrine manifestations include amenorrhea in women and impotence and gynecomastia in men. So what are the endocrine manifestations? So these include in women, so there is amenorrhea and impotence and gynecomastia in men. Hyperprolactinemia. So why is this hyperprolactinemia? So this is due to loss of normal inhibitory control by the hypothalamus. So along with hyperprolactinemia, so there also are other CNS manifestations. So these are papillary edema and elevated cerebrospinal fluid pressure and protein. So hyperprolactinemia, so this occurs due to loss of normal inhibitory control by the hypothalamus, and also there are other associated CNS manifestations like papillary edema and elevated CSF pressure and protein. So in 1/3 of the patients, even type 2 diabetes mellitus occurs. So in 1/3 of the patients, type 2 diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism and adrenal insufficiency are occasionally noted. So what are all the endocrine manifestations? Amenorrhea, impotence, hyperprolactinemia, hypothyroidism, adrenal insufficiency, and resembling histologically Castleman's disease due to interleukin-6 overproduction and hepatomegaly and lymphadenopathy. And then skin changes are diverse. So what are the skin changes that are seen? So these include hyperpigmentation, hypertrichosis, skin is also thickened, and there is also clumping. Digital clumping is also seen in Poem syndrome. So what are the skin manifestations? Hyperpigmentation, hypertrichosis, skin thickening and digital clumping. So what are the other manifestations? So these include peripheral edema, ascites, pleural effusion, fever and thrombocytosis. So what are the other manifestations? Peripheral edema, ascites, pleural effusion, fever and also thrombocytosis. Thrombocytosis is also seen. So not all the components may be present initially. So not all the components of Poem syndrome are present initially. So what is the pathogenesis? It is unclear, but what has been suggested is high circulating levels of the pro-inflammatory cytokines. So what are the pro-inflammatory cytokines which are high in number? Interleukin-1, interleukin-6, vascular endothelial growth factor and TNF. So what are the pro-inflammatory cytokines which are high in number? So these are interleukin-1, interleukin-6, vascular endothelial growth factor and TNF have been documented, and levels of the inhibitory cytokine transforming growth factor beta are lower than expected. So which is lower than expected? Inhibitory cytokine transforming growth factor beta. So so treatment of this myeloma, no? So this results in improvement in the other disease manifestations. So even here monoclonal plasma cell proliferative disorder is there. So if this myeloma is treated, so this will result in improvement in the disease manifestation. So patients are often treated similarly to those of the myeloma. So plasmapheresis does not appear to be of benefit in Poem syndrome. Has plasmapheresis got benefit in Poem syndrome? No. Plasmapheresis does not appear in Poem syndrome. Patients presenting with isolated sclerotic lesions may have resolution of neuropathic symptoms after local therapy for plasmacytoma with radiotherapy. So if we treat plasmacytoma with radiotherapy, so patients who are having this isolated sclerotic lesions, they have this resolution of neuropathic symptoms. Similar to multiple myeloma, novel agents and high dose chemotherapy along with autologous stem cell transplantation have been pursued in selected patients, and so these have been associated with prolonged progression free survival. Similar to multiple myeloma, novel agents and chemotherapy along with autologous stem cell transplantation, so this has been used for treatment in selected patients, and this is associated with prolonged